Hey guys, this is Craig Migliaccio from AEC Surface Tech, and today what we're going over is the ambient plus 30 rule for checking the charge of an older R22 system. So I want to describe what ambient plus 30 or ambient plus 25 means in reference to refrigerant charging. It's a question I get asked a lot, and there seems to be a desire for technicians to want to know other charging methods besides the total superheat and subcooling method. And so I just want to explain what this is and kind of why you shouldn't use it. So that's what I'm going to be going over today. The ambient plus 30 rule was applied to 10 SEER outdoor units, and the ambient plus 25 rule was applied to 12 SEER and sometimes 13 SEER outdoor R22 units. So this was only used for R22, and basically how you use it is you measure the outdoor ambient temperature first. So we see that we're reading 85 degrees, and that's the temperature outside right now, and the air is getting sucked into this coil right here and getting blown at the top. And so you have 86, and if you were to add 30 degrees to that, you're looking at 116 degrees as a target saturated temperature on your high side gauge. So right now we have our high side gauge hooked onto our liquid line right here, and we're reading a pressure on our outer ring. So outside ring's pressure, the green inner ring is the R22 saturated temperature at any given pressure. So we see that we're reading right about 253 PSIG on that outer ring. And if we were to bring it into the inner ring, we're looking at 117 degrees as a saturated temperature for R22 in the middle of this outdoor coil. So you got to remember that. We're measuring the pressure on the liquid line in order to find the saturated temperature of the refrigerant inside this outdoor condenser coil. So if this is 117 and that's 85, then that tells you that we have 32 degrees above the ambient temperature. So if you were going to apply the ambient plus 30 rule, you'd say that this is just slightly overcharged. It's right about correct. The problem with that is I know that this unit is undercharged right now. And so you're not getting the heat removal inside the building. It's not working effectively. So although this will get you somewhat close to what the unit should be running at, you really want to identify what the metering device is in the house or in the building. And in this case, it's a piston metering device, so it's a fixed orifice. You could also have a fixed orifice that looks like this at the inlet of the indoor evaporator coil. So on this particular job, we do not have a thermostatic expansion valve. So if you had a thermostatic expansion valve, then you can check the refrigerant charge using the subcooling charging method. Subcooling charging method is the right here, the saturated temperature minus the temperature on the line. So in this case, say we needed to measure subcooling, it would be 117 minus 108, so we're left with 9 degrees of subcooling. Actually, about 10 degrees right now of subcooling, 117 minus 107. So what we would need to do is then compare that to the rating plate. Up here on the rating plate, it would tell us to target subcooling if our unit had a thermostatic expansion valve. But in this case, we have a piston. So we're going to need to use the total superheat charging method to check the refrigerant charge of this system. Before I move on and tell you why this is undercharged, I just want to recap on that ambient plus 30 rule. So say our temperature, our saturated temperature in this outdoor coil was, say it was 105. 105 minus 85 would only give us 20 degrees above the ambient temperature, and that means that we would need to add refrigerant, you know, if we were going to use the ambient plus 30 rule. Say we had a saturated temperature of 125 degrees in the middle of the outdoor coil, and we read 85 for our ambient temperature, that would mean that we have 40 degrees over ambient, and that would mean that we're overcharged. So that's what that would mean if you're using the ambient plus 30 rule, but we gotta pay special attention to this vapor gauge no matter what the charging method is, the total superheat method or the subcooling method, because you need to make sure that the indoor coil, the saturated temperature in the middle of that coil stays above 32 degrees. If it gets below 32 degrees, the temperature of that indoor coil is gonna attract the humidity in the air crossing it, and it's gonna freeze on that coil. Now I wanna go over why I know that this unit's undercharged. And this unit has a piston orifice, so we have to use the total superheat method in order to check the refrigerant charge. In order to know what the target superheat needs to be, we have to take a indoor wet bulb temperature, and I checked that right before the return, right near the evaporator coil, and you see that we're reading 64 degrees. So 64 degrees, and we have an outdoor ambient temperature of 85 degrees, and we input that on a target superheat chart. So here's a chart from our book, The Refrigerant Charting and Service Procedures for Air Conditioning. So if you haven't got a chance to check that out, we've got the full outline and sample pages at our website at acservicetech.com. And right here you see our indoor wet bulb temperature of 64 degrees. And if you line that up with our outdoor dry bulb temperature of 85 degrees, outdoor dry bulb and outdoor ambient, they mean the same thing. So we see a target superheat of 11 degrees. And so now let's read our actual superheat on the system. And we have a reading of 73 degrees on our vapor line. And this is our low pressure suction vapor line right here. And it's this temperature minus the saturated temperature in the middle of the evaporator coil. Right now we're reading a pressure of about 71 PSIG. We bring that into the inner ring and we read about 41 degrees on our green inner ring at the saturated temperature at the evap coil. So 73 degrees minus 41, and we're left with 32 degrees of total superheat. So this system has way too much superheat. And when you have high superheat, that means that you're undercharged. If you have too low of a superheat, then that means you're overcharged. So that's the opposite for subcooling. If you had a high subcooling, then that means you're overcharged. If you have a low subcooling, then that means you're undercharged. But in this case, our system has a fixed orifice, so we know that we're undercharged, even though our ambient plus 30 would basically be saying that we have the correct charge. You always want to check your total superheat and your subcooling in order to check the refrigerant charge of a system. You don't want to try to go around that method of trying some other method or just measuring pressures only or delta T only, or, you know, there's a lot of different methods out there. And in fact, we take a whole chapter in our book discussing some of the methods that are just inefficient or just inaccurate. And if you want to learn more about checking the refrigerant charge or preparing a system for a refrigerant or for advanced techs, some troubleshooting methods, we have all that in our book. And there are sample pages and the full outline at our website at acservicetech.com. We also have our 1000 question workbook, and that's designed to test your knowledge to make sure that you're learning when you're trying to digest all that information in the book. We also have our self-study answer key so you can check to make sure that you're correct. We also have our quick reference polystyrene cards. So these can be used out in the field, and this is for checking the total superheat. That's for subcooling and delta T. Then we have our PT chart, and we have our refrigerant weights, troubleshooting guide with all of our indicators, and a walkthrough for a frozen evaporator coil in order to tell what the problem is. So these are all available over at Amazon.com and also at our website at acservicetech.com. Remember, we also have our free calculators, our free quizzes, our free articles and quick tips all at our website at acservicetech.com. So go ahead and check those out. Our ebook is available over on Google Play and our website. Hope you enjoyed yourself, and we'll see you next time at AC Service Tech Channel.